In this video, we will discuss the isometric projection problem number 32. So here the question is given, that means they given a picture, that is a front view and side view of this combination of two objects they given. We need to analyze this and we need to make an isometric view of this. By seeing this, we can see the first, this horizontal object is like a rectangular slab it is there, and this is attached to the bottom face. Bottom edge of this one is this is also like a rectangular prism, like these two objects there. We will construct the both objects separately and then we are going to add up this. And first, this one will construct this vertical, that is the rectangular prism. This length is 45 and the width is 15 and the height is 60 they given. So that's why this side is 15 and then this is become 45, 15, 45. Like this frame length will becomes, and the height we have to give the 60, and go to the line, visible line. You can start from this, and first you can enter 15 and angle is 30, then 45, angle is 150, and then again 15, angle is minus 150, and then 45, angle is minus 30. So after that, the height is given 60, so go to any one corner and give the height 60 and angle is minus 90. Then go to move, switch on the copy, select the line from the corner, you can pick it and place it to the remaining three corners, and then hold the control, select these two edges and push from the top and place it to the bottom. So one object is finished, and second one object, that is a rectangular slab, the dimensions they give here, we can see it here 60 length is there and width is 25. So that's why we can take it this one here, 60, angle is 30, then 25, angle is 150, then again 60, angle is minus 150, then 25, angle is minus 30. So we finished. And height, we can see here the height they give 15, so take any one corner and give the height 15 and enter minus 90. The angle should be 15, angle is minus 90, you can place it. And now go to move, select this, and we can hit this one and place it to the all the corners, and then here we need to select the one more edge, this because bottom edge should be touches here, so that's why we need to select the these three edges and take it up on the top corner and place it to the bottom, because we have to place this one should be come on the bottom face. So like this they given an image, and where to place this. By seeing this dimension they given, this object is having 10 mm from the away from the main this one prism. So once it is 10 and this is 25, remaining is 10, so total that means it is become exactly at the midpoint. So that's why go to the move, select this object and switch off the copy, and from the midpoint of this bottom edge, pick it and place it midpoint of this vertical, that is prism. After placing that, go to trim option. You can trim the edges coming behind of this, and you can trim it. And last step is go to the scale, select the object. Scale factor 0.814, enter, reduce it, and so like this this problem can be solved.